everyone. It's Miss Lori. It is Thursday, and I am happy to be with you today. I wanted to start our day asking you how you were feeling. You tell me, and then I'm going to tell you because I have some things to share today. So you tell me, you go first. How are you feeling today? Can you tell me why you're feeling that? Oh, excellent. Thank you for sharing. Can I share with you today? Miss Lori woke up just a little bit frustrated today. Yesterday, my video that I made for you guys didn't load till really late. I was having trouble with my internet. And so I was frustrated yesterday, and I'm still a little frustrated today. So I needed a fun song to get us going. Now, I absolutely love the song that we're going to sing, and you will too. You might want to teach your brothers and your sisters or your cousins this song, and we're going to sing Cuckoo Kangaroo Milkshake, okay? So before we get started, I want to talk to parents really quick or your adults in the room. Adults, if you can hear me, Go Noodle is a great resource. If you're tired of your kids watching the same things on Netflix or Disney Plus and need something new, Go Noodle is a great way to get some new learning songs in, and it also, they're just fun. This is Go Noodle and Cuckoo Kangaroo. You can also Google Cuckoo Kangaroo. They have a lot of fun, silly songs, and our classroom absolutely loves Cuckoo Kangaroo, and so those are great resources for you guys, and I try and put little things in for you guys too on your videos because you might be listening to me and need some new ideas. So go Noodle and Cuckoo Kangaroo. Now, kids, are you ready to do Cuckoo Kangaroo Milkshake? Are you ready? All right, let's do this. Maybe. Let me hit play again. Here we go.
Repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing. We can do it British. Oh, a milkshake. A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing.
Guys, I needed that today, and I absolutely love singing that song. That song makes me happy all the time. All right, so let's see if I can get my video screen bigger so that you guys can see me. And I just love that you guys were singing with me today. I absolutely loved it. All right, well, I was thinking, what can we do that's different?
We haven't done anything different lately.
So, what I figured we'd do was I brought home my whiteboard, our light-up board.
Ooh,
So I brought home our light-up board and our little shapes, and then I realized I can write on it. Instead of writing on my board back here, I can write here. So we're going to do some different things. I got a new letter bucket. I got that. And so, but first, we have got to sing our song, okay? We got to sing our morning songs now that we're ready and we're feeling better and feeling great. Let me get all of my weather things, but first we're going to do our good morning song. So, are you guys ready? Let's do it. Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? Wait a minute. I forgot. I told you yesterday that I wanted to have some instruments. And I didn't have any but my chime. So do you know what I did? Today, I downloaded an app on my phone. And I could do a shaker. How fun is that? So, I'm going to turn it up as loud as I can. And as we sing today, and you clap, I'm going to do our shaker, okay? Are you ready? I love it. See it? Isn't that cool? All right, so are you ready? This is the instrument I have today. I might have something different tomorrow. We'll have to wait and see. Are you ready? Okay, here we go. Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? How are you today? I'm fine, hope you are too. I'm fine, hope you are too. I'm fine, hope you are too. How are you today? Reach to your neighbor and touch their head. Reach to your neighbor and touch their head. Reach to your neighbor and touch their head. How are you today? Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? Hello, how are you? How are you today? What'd you think? Do you like it? I loved it. I was at my friend's house last night and I was practicing that. We put a song on and I was practicing that, my shaker, for you guys today. All right, where's my weather helpers? If you're here, raise your hand. I need you to go to a window. I need you to look outside. And we're going to say, what's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather today? Is it sunny? Is it cloudy? Is it windy? Is it rainy? Is it cold and snowy? What's the weather today? What's the weather? Excellent. You guys are so much fun. And this shaker just made me happy today. And we love shakers in our classroom, don't we? We love maracas. And what did we have before we left school? We did the bumping up and down in my little red wagon. Bumping up and down in my little red wagon. Bumping up and down in my little red wagon. What was the rest of it? I love that song. Let's see who. Miss Lori's gonna fix it with her hammer. Miss Lori's gonna fix it with her hammer. Miss Lori's gonna fix it with her hammer. All day long. I can't remember the rest of the words, you sillies. Anyway, we had the shakers that had what was inside, nails and screws. We couldn't get to them. They were glued shut, but we did that in our shaker, didn't we? So we love shakers at school. So I thought you guys might like this today. How fun is that? All right, I'll turn it off for now. Oh, no. Maybe. Now my phone's going to shake. All right. So I wanted to show you that today. All right. So we did our weather. We did our good morning song. We sang our cuckoo kangaroo song. And now it's time for us to do a new letter bucket. So are you ready? Okay. Our new letter bucket is this. We've not done this letter bucket at school. Do you know what letter bucket this is? Do you know what letter this is? It is Z. Very good. Z. 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 And we're going to find out some things that are in our bucket. But first, I want you to notice that the uppercase Z and the lowercase Z are the same, right? Except that one is bigger and one is smaller, but they look exactly the same. So this is the letter that you guys are gonna practice writing today, okay? But let's see what's in our letter bucket first. And I'm gonna push the screen down a little bit so you can see on my tray here, on my table. Oh, what's this? Zipper. Zipper begins with Z. I can zip, zipper. You hear that? Zipper. Zipper begins with Z. Do you have a zipper on your clothes this morning? Oh, I have a zipper on my jeans. Yeah. Okay. Oh, we know this animal. What is that? It's a zebra. Zebra does begin with Z. Zebra. We have a numeral, a number that begins with Z. Now, this is not an O. What numeral is this? Is this a 1 or a 5? That's right. It's a 0. 0 begins with Z. 0. Ooh. Zigzag. Do you see the zigzag? We're going to practice those today, too. I got a lot of ideas today. We're going to have good writing today. Zigzag, zigzag. You hear that? Oh, this is one of Miss Lori's favorite places to go. This is a sign for the zoo. Zoo begins with Z. Oh, Miss Lori loves the zoo. Do you remember when the zoo came to our classroom? And what animals did they bring? They brought a snake. That's right. Miss Abby brought a snake. And what else? Do you remember what those were? Hissing cockroaches. She brought those, didn't we? Did you know that Lachlan, too, did not get to hear the hissing cockroaches? But we did. They hissed for us. Well, I would really say they hissed for Miss Lori. They hissed for our classroom, didn't they? She got them to hiss. So we had hissing cockroaches and we had a snake from the zoo. Zoo begins with Z. Now this is a vegetable and I don't know if you guys have ever eaten this. Oh, we have eaten it in the classroom. It's zucchini. Do you remember? So when they cut up zucchini, it looks like the circles and you always say, oh, Miss Lori, are these cucumbers? Sometimes we have cucumbers, but sometimes we have zucchini. And what do we like to dip our zucchini in? Ranch! That's right. Oh, man. Oh, man. Eden and Miss Lori and Peyton, we eat ranch by the boxes, don't we? We love our ranch in Miss Lori's classroom. So, zucchini. So, here are our letters. Uppercase Z and lowercase Z. Zebra, Z. Okay? Z. Can I hear that sound? Z. Very good. Can you say goodbye to our zucchini? Z. Bye, zucchini. Can you say goodbye to our zigzag? Bye, zigzag. Can you say goodbye to our zero? Bye, zero. Can you say goodbye to our zipper? Bye, zipper. Can you say goodbye to our zebra? Bye, zebra. Can you say goodbye to our zoo? Bye, zoo. Okay, very, 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 very good. I love that letter bucket. And we're going to practice writing our, that's what we're going to practice writing before we do our shapes, okay? If you have a piece of paper, great. Grab a piece of paper, grab a crayon, grab a marker, grab a pencil. If you don't have anything right now, that's okay. I want you to watch. Parents, I want you to, I want to tell you just for a second, again, we do handwriting without tears in our classroom, and it's a great way to get them started writing. Matt Mann was a part of that. You can Google some on Pinterest, if you're on Pinterest. I Googled today, I wanted to show you, the handwriting without tears, uppercase letters. I didn't get a chance. I've sent them home before, but if you're like me, I have no idea where they're. I wouldn't know in my house where they were right now anyway. So I wanted you to know that there's an online resource that has handwriting without tears. And I Googled this on Pinterest, and you can't see it, but this has the letters and how we say them when we write them, okay? This is just a good resource if you're practicing writing with your kids. Uppercase letters, there's no lowercase, just uppercase for this one. And it will help you and have them practice when we say big line, big curve, little curve. So if you want that resource, just Google that and or look it up on the internet, and you should be able to see just a piece of paper that has that. And I'm sorry that I didn't get to send those home before. That was the plan. If we had school on that Monday, I was going to send home a bunch of stuff, and we just didn't have school. So handwriting without tears. All right, guys, let's see. I'm going to try and get you. Oh, man, this may be hard for you guys to see. I am going to, we may not be able to do it today because that is bright, isn't it? We're going to practice our letter Z, okay? We're going to go little line, big line, little line. And that's our Z, okay? Can you see that? That's our Z. You know what? In fact, I'm going to turn out all the lights in my house right now. So if you'll wait just a second, I am going to turn out the lights so that we can see that better, okay? So just give me a second. I'm going to turn out the lights. Are you practicing your letter? Practice your letter. All right, let me see if that's better. Ooh, I'm knocking everything over now. Okay, let's see if that's better. If you can see that better. Okay, there we go. That's better. Alexa, turn out the light. One more light. All right, there we go. So now we're going to do our lowercase Z, and that's just a little bit smaller. We're going to do little line. Little line and little line for Z. Can you see that? Good. So we're going to practice those Z's. Let's do that again. So we're going to do big line, and little line. And then we're going to practice our lowercase Z. Goes like that too. I love making Z's. Z's are a lot of fun. I'm going to make a bigger one for you. Little line,
big line.
Little line, Z. Excellent. Excellent. And let's do a lowercase one. Aren't those great? And then watch. So now that I know I can write on this with my marker, look, it just erases. How cool is that? I love our board. All right. So today, so I want you to practice your Z's. So I'm going to put at the top what I want you to practice. So we're going to practice our Z's today. Okay, uppercase and lowercase, because they're the same. The other thing that I want you to make was in our bucket. It was a zigzag. And so I want you to make a zigzag. And we're going to practice our zigzags. I'm going to make it down here. I love to practice zigzags. Don't they look like mountains to you? They have sharp points. So we're going to make zigzags. Can you make a zigzag with me? Zig, zag, zig, zag, zig. Zag. Isn't that great? I love the zigzags. Okay, I'm going to erase this part down here. And I was going to try something. Let's see. Can we make zigzags like this? That's a different motion, isn't it? That's harder. So this is our typical zigzag. So we're going to make zigzags up and down. Kind of like how we make a W or an M, right? I love zigzags. But if you want something harder, if you want to try something difficult, try and make it like a Z zigzag. So you're going to do sideways. You can do up and down like that. I love zigzags. So there's lots of different ways to make and practice our zigzags. So those are the things that I want you to. So you're going to practice your uppercase Z. You're going to practice your lowercase Z. You're going to practice your zigzags. And then there was another thing in our bucket that we can practice making that starts with Z. Zero. Zero. So let's make some zeros. Zero, zero. I'm reminded of Pete the Cat and the four groovy buttons. Do you remember? He had four groovy buttons. And then, so you could make these into buttons. Look. And you could tell the story of Pete the Cat. Should we tell the story of Pete the Cat? All right, I'll tell the story of Pete the Cat in a minute. So, zero, remember he had zero. One, take away one, equals zero. All right, so I'll tell that story in a minute. So I want you to practice your uppercase Z, your lowercase Z, your zigzags, your zeros, and then your name. Again, adults, if you're in the room, if they're getting ready for kindergarten, we are beginning to practice using lowercase letters except for the beginning letter. The beginning letter is always uppercase. If they're struggling with that and they push back on you, that's okay. Have them write in uppercase letters. Okay? Or whose name is this? All right. So let's do that today. We haven't done our friends' names before. So for those of you who are in Lachlan 1 that are watching, I'm going to start with a new name today. And I know this little boy is watching, and his name is Sam. Sam is watching today. Hi, Sam. All right, Lachlan 1, are you ready? Let's do our friends' names. I'm going to start over here. Let's start with whose name is that? Elijah. Hi, Elijah. Good job. All right. I'm going to start with whose name is. Oh, it's hard to write upside down, so you're going to have to forgive me. Whose name is that? Peyton. Hi, Peyton. Okay, now we're going to write whose name is next. Whose name is that? Hi, Mitchell. Good. All right, I'm going to go back over here. Remember, we always start on the left side of our paper and write. So we have Elijah, Peyton, Mitchell, and then I'm going to write whose name is this? Hi, Karen. Okay, whose name is this? Hi, Lasana. Excellent. Whose name is this? Did I write that right? No, I didn't. Hang on. It's hard to write backwards. I still didn't. Yeah, I did. Okay. Whose name is that? This one. Hi, Legend. All right, so let's go over our names again. So we have Elijah, Peyton, Mitchell, Karen, Lasana, Legend. Good. All right, I'm going to erase and do some more names. Okay, are you ready? All right, I am going to do whose name is that? Hi, Fatima. Excellent. Whose name is this? Hi, Liam. Okay, who's next? Let's see. Okay. Whose name is that? I keep making my Y's backwards, people. Whose name is that? Hi, Lucy. Okay. All right. Are you ready? I'm going to start over here. Whose name is that? Hi, Melanie. Okay, next. Whose name is this? Did I make that right? Yeah. Whose name is this? Hi, Eden. Excellent. Excellent. All right, let's see who's next. Hi, Adeline. Excellent, guys. Okay, so let's go over these names again. So we have Fatima, Liam, Lucy, Melanie, Eden, Adeline. Excellent.
Beep, 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 beep.
Okay, here we go. Whose name is next? Here we go. All right. Oh, sorry about that. All right, whose name is next? Whose name is this? Hi, Lemire. Excellent. All right. I gotta make sure that I get everybody's names. Yep, Mitchell. Who am I missing? Oh. Whose name is this? Hi, Aaliyah. Good job, guys. All right. Are you ready? All right. Whose name is... let me make sure that I get everybody. Whose name is this? Whose name is this? Hi, Ari. Excellent job, guys. You guys are doing so, so great. All right. Let me make sure that I get everybody's name. I have one more person. I have to go around the room in my mind and make sure that I get everybody's names. Ah! Whose name is this? How could I forget? I've not been in school for so long. Whose name is this? Hi, Lily. Excellent. So let's say everybody's names. Lemire, Aaliyah, Ari, Lily. Excellent. So I have four people's names on my board. Two begin with the same letter, and two begin with another letter. So what do Lemire and Lily's names begin with? Excellent. L. Very good, guys. And what does Aaliyah and Ari's name begin with? What's their first letter? A. Very good. You guys are doing great. So tomorrow we'll do a little bit of whose names begin with what, and we'll see whose letter. We haven't done that in a while. Whose letter has the most names in our classroom, okay? So again, today I want you to make your Z, your zigzag, your zero, and your name, okay? This is Miss Lori's name. All right, so I am going to erase this, and I will tell you the story of the groovy buttons. So I need a groovy button. Let's see if I can make a shirt. Do you mind if I turn this for a minute? Okay, Miss Lori is not too great at making shirts, but maybe I could figure it out today. There we go. Okay, so there's our shirt, and let's make four groovy buttons. Okay, can you count them with me? One, two, three, four. And that's funny. Four groovy buttons, and we have four dots on each of our buttons. Okay, are you guys ready? Pete the Cat loved his favorite shirt. I'm not going to be able to say the exact words because I can't remember them exactly. So he had four groovy buttons on his shirt. Let's count them. One, two, three, four. And let's make our four. Four groovy buttons. Pop! Oh no! One of the buttons popped off and rolled away. How many buttons were left? 3, that's right. So 4, take away 1, because we took away 1, equals, right, 3. 3 buttons left. Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He just kept walking along and singing his song. My buttons, my buttons, my 3 groovy buttons, my buttons, my buttons, my 3 groovy buttons. Oh, no! Pop! Another button popped off and rolled away. How many buttons were left? So we had 3 at the beginning, and how many now? 2, very good. 3 buttons, take away 1 button equals 2. Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along and singing his song. My buttons, my 2 groovy buttons, my buttons, my buttons, my 2 groovy buttons. Pop! Oh, no. Another button popped off and rolled away. How many buttons were left? That's right. 2. 1, right, 1. So we had 2 buttons, we took away 1 button, and we have 1 button left. Did Pete cry? Goodness, no. He kept walking along and singing his song. My buttons, my buttons, my 1 groovy button, my button, my button, my 1 groovy button. Pop! Oh, no! The last button popped off and rolled away. How many buttons were left? Don't ruin the story. How many buttons on his shirt were left? That's right, 0. 1 button, take away 1 button, equals 0. We're going to practice that today. Did Pete look down at his buttonless shirt? And what do you think he saw? That's right. His belly button. And he sang this song. My button, still have my belly button. Woo, my button, still have my belly button. Excellent. I love that story. The moral of the story is buttons come and buttons go, but we keep on singing. Excellent, guys. I love that book. You guys love Pete the Cat. Here, you want to say hi to Pete? Here he is. Hi, Pete. How are you today? All right. All right. I've got my bucket of shapes, and we're going to sort some shapes. I love our shapes. Our shapes. Our shapes. I love our shapes. Oh, yeah. My shapes. I love my shapes. Yeah. I love shapes. I love shapes. Oh, do you love shapes? Because I love shapes. Woo! All right. I've got some shapes on our board, and we're going to talk about sorting, okay? How can we sort? Can you think? You want to sort by color first? Okay, let's sort by color. So let's start with, what color is this? Green, that's right. Let's put all the greens over here. Get out from under there, sir. There we go. All right, what shapes do you want to, or what color do you want to do next? Let's do red. Red, red. And let's do my favorite color, blue, blue, and then we'll do yellow. Now, these are orange. So we're going to do yellow and orange. So we have our piles of shapes. So we have our red shapes. We have our green shapes, we have our blue shapes, we have our yellow shapes, and we have our orange shapes. That's right, very good. Now I was going to sort them in a different way, and I was thinking all of the shapes are the same color, so I was hoping that the shapes would be different colors, but they're not. Well, yeah, the ones that I pulled out are all the same shape. Well, that's not true. That's not true. We could do them by shapes. So if I sorted them by shape, these triangles would be with the green triangles. The orange triangles would be with the green triangles. See that? These are rectangles, trapezoids, hexagons. Okay. Now, I was thinking of a different way that we could sort them. We could sort them by big shapes and by little shapes. So if I were to sort them by big shapes and little shapes, let's see what we would have. I think these are our biggest shapes here, right? But I also think the green ones are big. And which other ones do you think are big? Good. I agree with you. I think the rectangles are big too. And then these are little. Yep. So when we're sorting things, the easiest way is to sort them by color. But I also think that we can sort them by shape and by size, right? Okay, so let's sort them out by color again. Okay, and I want you to look at the red shapes, okay? Can you tell me how many red shapes there are? That's right, there are two. We can just use our eyes and we can look at that and we can know that there are two. Very good. And if we do our yellow shapes, can you tell me without counting how many yellow shapes we have? Let's count to see if you're right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. Good. All right, let's count our orange shapes down here. Can you tell me how many orange shapes we have if I line them up like this? How many are there? Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Did you say 3? Okay. Let's line up. How many green shapes do we have? That's right. We have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. Now let's count our rectangles. Can you use your eyes and tell me how many there are? Good. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Excellent. Very, very good, guys. Very, very good. So which one has less? Which shape has less? Yeah, the red ones have less. Which one, which group has more? Which one has the most? Did you say blue? Because you would be right. Blue has 5, so they have the most. And then we have a 3 and 2 4s, right? Good. So most blue. This has the most, more, and this has less. Very good. Excellent, guys. Very good. What letter did I make with my tiles? What letter did I make? What letter is this? Look how fun that is. T. Very good. T. And if I put one on the bottom like this, what letter did I make? I made I. Very good. I love to build with shapes. Let's see, what happens if I put 2 together like this? What did I make? Yeah, how fun is that? And then, let's see if I have, I don't think I have one. I was going to try and make a tree, and we'll have yellow trees. We'll pretend like all of the leaves have turned yellow. How fun is that? Let's make a taller tree. Or it could be a flower. If I move that out of the way, we could pretend like, let's make some flowers. Let's see. It's springtime, and in springtime, flowers bloom, doesn't it? Don't they? How many flowers do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. Excellent. You guys are awesome. And remember, you guys have come to me and talk to me about this. If I put 2 triangles together like this, what shape did I make? What shape did I make? What shape is that? It's a diamond. And if I turn it like this, what shape is that? It's now a square, right? So I took, here's a triangle, then I put 2 together to make a diamond, and then I'm going to turn it like this, and now I've made a square. Woo-hoo! Look, I'm going to make a person. Woo-hoo, woo-hoo. I made a person. Awesome. awesome, guys. You guys are amazing. Amazing. So I just want to say goodbye and have a super, super fantastic day. See you guys soon.